All right, guys, and we are back. All right, Mr. Ed, I had to stick that pin.
Mr. Ed.
Okay, what I could call you, Mr. Robinson. Which one we call you? Ed Robinson. No, listen, no, seriously.
You went, it until you feel like
you
calm,
see? You know, like, the difference. Yeah, we got a connection here, guys. No, but seriously, so you went so fast. So you started at 13.
Yeah.
At 14 now, I'm doing it professionally, and I've even gotten paid. But then you're in California now, and you're signed. How does that even work for the people out here who are striving to get to where you are? They don't know what that journey consists of.
Basically, what happened to me is I went through the whole, as a drummer.
Yeah.
I went through the whole line of playing drums in hotel bands.
Oh, wow.
I went through it, playing drum with, you know, you name it, as far as the Jamaican superstars concerned.
Oh, wow.
You know, but the one person who actually gave me my break was a singer called Bob Andy.
Mm.
You know, that brought me into Kingston because I was basically on the North Coast where tourist people
okay, I know
do
what you mean.
The hotel scenes. Mm-hmm. You know, so from doing that, I get into Kingston where, you know, where I could rub shoulder with the likes of the Peter Tosh.
Yeah.
You know, the Wheelers band.
Yes.
You know, because when the drummer from Wheelers got killed, I replaced him in Bob Marley's band.
Oh, wow.
You know, but by this time, you know, Bob Marley had passed.
Right, but still.
Yeah, you know, so I've been through that, you know, all of that little mess and, you know, start finding myself. Then I realized, but I was always getting fired from bands. Like,
why?
Every band I join or be a part of, eventually I get fired. I probably was a little bit too hot-headed and, you know.
At least you're honest. You know, I love it.
Yeah, you know it, girl. Back then, you never really see it, but, you know, looking back now, you actually see where you actually went wrong.
Yeah.
You know, but that was my whole vibe of I wanted to learn things so quick and just be professional and be efficient. You go in and you start working and other people messing up.
Right.
You don't really you don't have no patience for that.
Oh, I got you. Know, okay.
Yeah, you don't have no patience for that, so. Getting kicked out of band, eventually just decided that, look here, because most band I play with,
mm-hmm.
I always sing one or two songs as a drummer.
Oh, wow.
So
you're back there, you're playing the drums, and there's a mic for you to sing?
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think I've seen that. Have I seen this before?
Yeah, man, what if a band do that, man?
Maybe I haven't seen enough bands.
Right, what if a band do that? And then from there, you know, I realized that I kind of tired of this background thing, you know, because I watched the glory and the props that the people up front was getting.
Right.
And you know, your ego say you want some of that.
I'm telling you that. I love the honesty, man. We have to keep it.
Your ego say, want some of that glory there. So that's when I start making the transition.
But let me ask you a question now. So before you made your transition into getting in the forefront, who was that supporting you? Because it almost sounds like you were doing this by yourself. I'm just kind of curious what gave you that energy to say, I want to go from here to here to here, you know?
Coming from where I come from.
Yeah, brothers and sisters?
Yeah, man, Wolip. Probably about, I have 11 brothers and sisters.
Oh, no, you have a whole heap.
Yeah, Wolip. Mm-hmm. You know, so coming from where I come from was basically right on the poverty boat.
Got you.
So that basically was my drive.
Yeah.
I never liked that thing.
Got you.
I never liked that thing called poverty or being poor. I have nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
I don't even remember it.
Yeah.
You know, so I just fly past
that stage
100 miles an hour, past it. You know what I mean? So
getting to that
level where you know, I know where I wanted to go,
yeah,
who I wanted to be, what I wanted to be. So I was just, you know, hot-headed.
Yeah.
In such a way that, listen, you're not going to stand in my way.
Mm.
Nothing stand in my way.
Well, that was pretty bold of you, and that was good, especially coming from Jamaica, then coming to make that transition into LA. Did you know anyone?
No one?
Like
Just the people from the record company who brought me here.
And then you stayed here? You didn't go back?
Nah, didn't go back. Going back to Jamaica was like going back to the poverty that I left.
Oh my God. It's a beautiful thing yeah. Because you being here means over 10 albums. It means over 200 songs. You know, it means
Don't get me wrong. I did a lot of Ed Robinson's basically was created in Jamaica, not here.
Oh,
you
wait.
Know, that persona, Ed
wait,
Robinson.
Wait. I got to pay some more bills.
Yeah.
So you could tell me about That means he doesn't want to pay him, guys. Listen, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Yeah, man.